Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. This is the AuraFlow 240 liquid cooler for your PC. I chose the snow edition because it matches my PC case of white very nicely. I'll go through the unboxing, installation, review, coolers, all that stuff. I'm gonna get into it, so stay tuned. Now, ever since I built my first PC, this is the first PC I built, I've been rocking the AMD Wraith cooler that came with my 3700X chipset, and it was doing an okay job, like I mentioned before, but it just wasn't enough, and I want to push those frames, play those games in 1440 and stream at the same time. I need a little bit more, so I decided to get this water cooler. Right here, we got the box in front of us, getting ready to unbox it. It's a lot of stuff in this box, man. In addition to the water cooler itself, an AL pump, got a lot of interesting pieces in it, and it comes prepared to fit onto Intel and AMD motherboard, so this water cooler can fit both. There we got the instruction booklet, and those are the fittings I was just talking about. Those are the fittings to each of it has like adapters for AMD and Intel. Now, as we take it out of the box, let's go over some of the parts here. And you have the water radiator itself with the pump head right there, and it's got two connections coming off of one power, one RGB. You've got your fans, nice little sets of fans, not the highest of quality, but they'll do the job. You've got your power adapter, connectors, remote control switches right there, and these are the fittings for AMD and Intel. It'll tell you in the instructions which one to use. So just read those instructions and it'll tell you how to put that on there and assemble it. Those are the extra screws and everything for the fittings and mounts and all that. But please pay attention to that. You want to mix up your screws here and screw something into the radiator wrong and burst it. So I didn't have that problem because I watched other videos ahead of time. But just be careful and be mindful of that. All right, now that we got everything in the box, we're going to need the tools. Only thing I needed was some thermal paste and my screwdriver. And our first job is to get this AMD Wraith cooler out of there. Just get it on out of there. Now that we've got that AMD Wraith cooler uninstalled and taken out, our next job will be to assemble the fans onto the radiator, which wasn't hard at all. You just take those extra long screws, screw them in each one of the four contacts, and it's all gonna repeat that process again. But my problem was, I should have put all the cords on one side, both fans. I should have put the cords on one side. I didn't, right? So you can see here, I put that fan catty corner and I ended up having to jury rig some of these cords. Had to take it back apart, refix it. So be careful. Just make sure I would suggest you put the cords from each fan on the same side. That way you don't have any problems connecting them or putting it all together. Now that we got those fans installed, the next step is to attach the radiator to the top of the PC. I chose the top of my PC because the fans that were pre-installed don't give me enough leverage or room to get it to the front, so I had to put it on the top. And my graphics card is real beefy. I've got a GPU 5700 XT THicc III from SFX, so it takes up a lot of space down there at the bottom. So I couldn't possibly put it on the front, so I had to choose to put it at the top here. It wasn't hard to screw that right up at the top. I had to be mindful of the RAM, though. The RAM was bulging against it and the CPU power cord. So it was a tight fit, but it was real snug in there. But I got it done. I got it in there and I got it done. Now, here's the part I hear a lot of people forget. Do not forget to take this sticker off. to expose the metal plate on the AI, the pump head. All right, they have, the pump comes with thermal paste, but I decided to use some thermal paste I had left over for my installation. So put like a nice pea size on that CPU. I had left over, I just smeared it onto the pump head. Put that down for a second while I get the screws ready. Once I got those screws ready, cleaned up the area, picked that back up, and we just orientated to where the pump head rests against the CPU and line those screws up and take the other screw heads and screw them on in. You should be done with that part. Now, up until this point, everything was easy, straightforward, simple. Then I got to the cords. Now listen up, this is kind of tricky. Each part has two cords. So the pump head has a power and a RGB, and each fan has a RGB and a power cord. You'll know that because the power cord has four pins, the RGB pin has four pins and arrows on them. They come with an adapter that you have to put the two, what I did was I took two of the power cords from the fans, attach them to the adapter right here. You go on two on one side, and then it's got another side. That side right there, I attached to the CPU board itself. I took the AIO pump head power cord, and I attached that to the motherboard. So two of them attached to the motherboard. Then I ran the RGB cords, that's them right there, and they have the arrow on them, like I told you. You line those up, and there is a little remote that comes with the system, and I use that remote to bridge the connection from those little pins right there to the adapter that it comes with. And then I put the adapter in with the remote into my Molex connector on my power supply. So in summary, the fans and the pump head are connected to the motherboard. The RGB lighting itself, all the RGB lighting, is hooked into directly to my power support, so power supply. That's how I connected them. So read the book, look up a little bit more. Hopefully this will help you out getting yours connected. Now just listen to the Wraith cooler versus the water cooler sound decibel. Now, let us admire our nicely, freshly installed water cooler, the handiwork it took, and just look at it in all its glory. Take it in, boys. Bask in its glory. I am by no means an expert on testing things, but I do know how to look at numbers and graphs. So I used AMD Ryzen Master to test out my CPU temperature, which is a 3700X again. And here what it was sitting with the Wraith cooler. It sat around 49 to 55. It would idle in between there. This is idle with the Wraith cooler. Next up, once we installed our water cooler, our AuraFlow 240, this is the results. We're sitting at about, I see 37 to 44 is what I get. That is the average, it drops in between. I wasn't able to get 30 on camera, but I did get the 40. It idles at 37 to about 44°C. Now, I don't normally play Fortnite, but I used it as sort of a benchmark here. So I put the CPU, GPU under a load of Fortnite, and it started to go up to about 53, 55, just playing Fortnite. Then I applied a test that the Ryzen Master tool has, applied that, put it under a heavy load. And as you can see, it went up to about 67, I believe. It would not go over 67 as before. I was getting up high heats like of 80, about 80, 81 Celsius with the Wraith cooler, which is pretty good for the Wraith cooler, but it wasn't good enough for me. So I just broke down. This is what made me break down and just get the water cooler, because I said I need something. If I'm going to be streaming, playing video games, all that stuff at the same time, I'm going to keep that 3700X cool. And for me, this is a good range, somewhere around 65. And then when we booted down, took the test off, you can see it drops back down in the 50 range here. And when I turned the game off altogether and put it back down to idle, you'll see the numbers drop back down to 40. And that's it, guys. It wasn't that hard. Other than the wiring, it was pretty simple, kind of intense, a nice learning lesson. And I hope this video helped you out. Hope it gets you right in the future. If it does, leave a like and some comments down below, and I'll get with you later. Thanks for watching, guys.